So here's an interesting experiment that I just did. It might provoke some of your thinking about your own work. I went to my AI generator that I use usually to write blog articles and copy for my website and stuff like that. And I wrote this prompt right here. The darker blue is actually, I wrote, write a prompt for an AI image generator that captures the essence of a stage hypnosis experience. To which the generator then wrote this bigger paragraph that I have highlighted in light blue. I copied that. Then I went over to the AI image generator that I use, which is called Midjourney. And I dropped that prompt into Midjourney. And it came up with this. It's interesting. I did not tell it to do black and white, but it did it all in black and white. But it gave me, and this is what Midjourney does. It gives you four images. And then what you can do is if there's one that you're like, well, that's got potential, you can tell it to do it again. Now, what's interesting is the prompt, the image should convey blah, blah, blah. I thought it said the atmosphere should be full of energy with bright lights and bold colors. And yet, it did not do that at all, which is very strange and unusual. Usually when you give a command like that, it really does listen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try it again. Maybe tweak it a little bit. Let's take out the middle sentence and focus on the bright lights and bold colors. Let's see if that just somehow produces a different result. So see, at first, 0%, it's just getting started. It's all blurry. 15%, the four images will just keep getting better and better. Now, isn't this interesting? The earlier version, it's just taking out that sentence. Now, look at how much color I have. So it's almost like somehow the sentence I took out, even though it wasn't talking about color and stuff, it was influencing the outcome so that you was getting a black and white image on more than one attempt. And I took the one out and now it's totally going the other way. These are pretty crazy, right? 93%, they're almost done. So when it does them, it drops it at the bottom again as a finished product. Yeah. So here's my four things. What do I like? I kind of like three and four, the bottom two. So then what you can do is these V buttons are for that. So V3 is for the bottom left. V4 is bottom right. You can make it do new iterations based on those. So I click V3. It'll work up four new versions of that. I click V4. It'll work up four new versions of that. So now we'll come down. Look at how much content people are just cranking out on this thing. It's amazing. So fast all day long. Just gajillions of images being made. All right, so now it gives me four versions. I'm not in love with any of them necessarily, but they still might make a fun social media post. Now what you want to do is, these are almost like the early versions. You have them make an even better version. That's the use, upscale. You make an upscaled version of what you want to keep. And I kind of like four. I make an upscale of four. And I'll make an upscale of this one as three. I'm going to make an upscale of, no, four. I'll make an upscale of four. Now it's going to churn out that bigger, better version. And that's what you keep. So then I click it and I do right click, save image as, save it to my desktop. And now I have it. And then down here, right click. Oops, I gotta put it up now. Right click, save image as, save to desktop, and I've got it. So, takes a little bit. What'd that take? I don't know. 10 minutes. I got two images, neither one of which I'm like totally gaga in love about, but each of which I could use for a social media post at the very minimum to get some attention. And they're not from a stock site, right? So I'm the only person that has them, unless someone else here on Midjourney takes them, which is fine if they do. But I've got them. They're my own original creation. I can take them and use them, and they're not going to be showing up in a whole bunch of other people's stuff. And you just sort of keep going through this process and going through this process. It's pretty interesting, I think, but I like to geek out about stuff like this. So